Okay, dear students, welcome to today's class, that is classification of mode of action of disinfectants. So it is also called the antimicrobial chemical agents. So characteristics of an ideal antimicrobial agent, you can see different parameters will be their characteristics. One is antimicrobial agent, antimicrobial activity, solubility, okay, then stability, non-toxicity to humans and other animals, homogeneity. Okay, homogeneity, then non-combination with extraneous organic materials, other organic materials, then toxicity to microorganisms at room or body temperature, capacity to penetrate, non-corroding and non-staining, deodorizing stability, ability, then detergent capabilities, availability. So total 12 parameters is there. So 12 parameters, characteristics, one is antimicrobial activity. So antimicrobial activity, if you see, the capacity of a substance to kill or inhibit microorganisms. So it is going to inhibit or kill the microorganisms growth at a low concentration. That is very important. Then second point is solubility. They are soluble in organic solvents or inorganic solvents. That means chemical antimicrobial agents soluble in water or other solvents. Stability. So these chemical agents are stable if you store for long duration. Are they stable or not? So the stability is very important. Means if you should store this microbial agent for long duration, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, like that. Then non-toxicity to humans and other animals. So it should be toxic. That means chemical antimicrobial chemical should be toxic to microorganisms and it should not be injurious to human and other animals. Then while keeping that antimicrobial agents, homogeneity. So it is homogeneous or not. After storing for 1 year, 2 years, it should be homogeneous. There should not be any turbidity. So that is the point. Then second, next point is non-combination with extraneous organic materials. Since many antimicrobial agents, when they combine with the proteins and carbohydrates, they will undergo complexation and their antimicrobial activity decreases. So this, due to that one, they should not form any complex with the proteins. Then toxicity to microorganisms at room and body temperature. So they should show antimicrobial should be toxic to microorganisms at room temperature. Then capacity to penetrate the tissues. So if it is the penetration power is more, then antimicrobial activity increases. If penetration power is less, then antimicrobial activity decreases. Then non-corroding and non-staining. So they should not antimicrobial activity chemicals when we are putting to the any metals. They should not put and they should not form any dust. So that is the meaning. Then deodorizing ability, that means antimicrobial should have a good smell. So when we are putting on any living or non-living object, they should not be, they should remove the odor, bad odor from the substance. Then detergent capacity. So detergent capacity means cleaning capacity. So whatever we are detergent using for the clothes cleaning purpose, that is also antimicrobial agent. So cleaning purpose is called as a detergent, whether we are using for clothes or we are using for any objects, utensils used in cooking purpose or some antimicrobial effective studies purpose, autoclaves, glassware cleaning. So all those detergents, a capability of a antimicrobial is important. Then availability. So that how detergents are easily available in the market, so same way antimicrobial compound should be easily available in the market. So this is what are the major ideal characteristics of antimicrobial agents. Then definition of terms, the terms which are used in microbiology, that is sterilization. That means completely free from microorganisms. That is called sterilization. Sterile, sterilized material, sterilization process. Then second point is disinfectant. That means the agent or chemical that kills the growing forms, but not necessarily the resistant spores. So that means it is not killing the resistant spores, but it is killing the other living organisms. Then it is detergents are mainly applied to the non-living objects. That means inanimate objects, not applying on the living objects. Human beings, animals, we won't apply. Then antiseptics. A substance that opposes sepsis, that means prevent the growth of the microorganism by destroying them or inhibiting their growth and metabolism, usually associated with substances applied to the body. So whatever the human body or animal body, we are applying the solutions to remove the bacteria, that is antiseptics. Then fourth word we are using is sanitizer, a agent that reduces the microbial population to safe level as judged by public health requirements, that is 99.9% bacteria should be killed. So that substance is called as a sanitizer. And nowadays we are getting the coronavirus purpose living sanitizers which are applying on the animate objects, animate animals. But previously sanitizers are mainly used on the inanimate objects, particularly dairy product. So dairy utensils cleaning purpose, then food plants cleaning purpose, then glass, dishes, utensils in restaurants. So restaurants, glassware and utensils cleaning purpose they are using. Then fifth one is germicide. Or is also called as a microbicide, the agent that kills the growing forms but not necessarily the resistant spores. That means here germicide also not killing the spores but it is killing the living organisms, that is germicide. Germicides are commonly used for all kinds of germs. Germs means microbes, fungus, bacteria, spores, all these are germs. Then bactericide, particularly bacteria killing, bactericide, virus killing, viricide, fungus killing, fungicide, okay, spores killing, sporicide, so respective words they are using. Then bacteriostasis, that means inhibiting the growth of bacteria, that means now example 10% bacteria is there in a solution. So that means it should be 10% only, it should not increase. So that means inhibiting the growth, but stagnant microbes will be there. So bacteriostasis, fungistatic, microbistatic, so stopping the growth of the respective microorganisms. Then microbial agents, so antibacterial agent, antifungal agent, antiviral agents, we are using antimicrobial, antibiotics are coming under the antimicrobial agents, which are also called as a chemotherapeutic agents. Then next we are using the selection of a chemical agent for practical application. So whatever the chemical agents is there, we are selecting it for the practical application. Nature of the material to be treated, a chemical agent used to disinfect contaminated utensils might be quite unsatisfactory for application to the skin. That means nature of the material to be treated, that means we are treating the material, that means whether it is a cloth, utensils, bathroom or some other body surface. So based on that respective antimicrobial agent we should use. Then type of microorganisms, whether it is a bacteria, fungus, virus, like that specific type of microorganisms, spirochete, so all are coming under the microorganisms. We should select the antimicrobial agent. Environmental conditions, that means the environment in which we are applying the antimicrobial agent, that environmental conditions means temperature of a solution, pH of a solution, time exposure of the solution to antibiotic, concentration of the antibiotic, presence of extraneous organic material, affect the antimicrobial efficiency. Then classification of chemical antimicrobial agents. So this is very important in syllabus, they will ask 5 marks and 10 marks. Phenol and phenol compounds, alcohols, halogens, heavy metals and their compounds, dyes, detergents, quaternary ammonium compounds, aldehydes, gaseous agents. So these are the different groups is there, groups of chemical antimicrobial agents. We should discuss all these groups, mechanism of action, and their use in the society, available concentrations, everything we should discuss. So let us see, in next class we will discuss all these antimicrobial classification agents in detail.